bottom is blue.
Hey, sing the story of
Leaf Sailor Me Wick was a big and some blue.
In the steerage glass below.
I'll sing you a song of the king of the sea.
And it's hey, to the story of
the ruler of all of the oceans.
Perfection grips me out on the open sea, surrounded by nothing but water and imagination.
Oh yes, it's simply delightful.
The salt on your skin and the wind in your hair, and the waves as they ebb and they flow. We're miles from the shore, and guess what? I don't care.
As for me, I'm about to heave ho. My lord, please, enough seafaring. The talk of mer people and the king of the sea is nautical nonsense.
There it is again! Straight ahead!
Your majesty, it's time you return to court and take up your father's crown.
That's not the life for me, Grimsby. Now follow that voice. To the ends of the earth if we have to.
Aye, aye, captain.
There's mermaids out there in the bottom.
Merfolk, welcome. It's wonderful to see you all here. Ever since the sea witch robbed us of our dear queen, celebrations like these have lifted my spirits. Thank you.
Presenting the court composer, Horatio Vernalius Ignatius Crustaceous Sebastian.
Oh, sire, you're gonna love this number. I wrote it for my star pupil.
And who might that be?
Your youngest. Such a voice, that child. Notes as clear as ice. Pitch as pure as water. Why, I haven't heard such a magnificent sound since Dark Queen.
May she rest in peace.
Oh, you're gonna be so proud. If only that girl would show up rehearsals once in a while.
Well, what are we waiting for? Let the festivities begin.
Yes, let the festivities begin.
Again, child. I was counting on you most of all.
Ariel, where in the name of Poseidon is that girl?
Hey, Ariel, there you are.
Just look, Flounder. The sun, the sand, isn't it the most beautiful place you've ever seen?
I don't know, Ariel. I'm not sure we ought to be up here.
Don't be such a guppy.
A guppy? I'm as brave as you are. I'm not afraid of anything.
What about sharks?
Where?
Oh, Flounder, you really are a guppy.
I am not.
Aww. Look what I found today. Isn't it the most beautiful thing you've ever seen in your entire life?
Whoa, cool. What is it?
I don't know. But I bet Scuttle will. Come on, I'll race you.
Hey, wait for me.
Scuttle!
Mermaid off the port bow! Ariel, how are you doing, kid? Whoa, what a swim!
Scuttle, look what we found.
More human stuff, eh? Let me see.
Can you
wow,
tell us
this is very special.
Can you tell us what it's for?
It's a dingle hopper.
A dingle hopper?
These babies are fantabulous, absolutely indispensary. When it comes to dingle hoppers, I'm a regular encyclopedia. Said you wanna have a head like the folks that live up there, that'll flap their wings. While you can absolutely dandy if you use one of these handy little thingy-majigs.
Dingle bobs, jigs, bobs.
Pick up the dingle hopper just like so. Twirl it the way I'm twirling. Give it a little yank and there you go. You're what they call the dogs. No.
Wonderful stuff. Thank you.
A thingy more, a watch McGee. That's all you need to bring you up to stuff. With proper dingle hopper grooming, rest assured you'll look good. We know, cause we know human stuff.
Does this thing really work?
Sure thing, kid. I ain't just blowing smoke. It makes music like the likes that you've never heard.
Music? Oh no, the concert! My father's gonna kill me!
The concert was today?
Come on, Flounder. Thanks, Scuttle!
Anytime, sweet! Anytime!
Oh, sources of the sea, oh, beauty of the brine, hail to the sea witch, hail to Ursula.
Flotsam, my pet, Jetsam, my darling, come to me, my little sea spies. Mama's feeling woe begone, banished to the nether regions of the sea. No food, hardly any company. I'm simply wasting away.
Poor Ursula.
Yes, poor me. What news do you have?
King Triton and the merfolk are celebrating your defeat. And he blames you for the queen's demise.
Of course he does. Use a little black magic to help out a few merfolk, and this is the thanks I get? Well, now it's time to turn the tides on Triton. We've just got to find his Achilles heel, a weakness that will crack his armor.
The king is terribly devoted to his daughters, especially the youngest, with a beautiful voice. But she missed the celebration.
Apparently Ariel takes her gift for granted, just like her mother did. A woman doesn't truly know how precious her voice is until she's been silenced.
Silenced.
You two, find out what that girl really wants. Then lure her here to my lair. I'll whip up a quick spell to make her dreams come true, and once I have her trapped, Trident will come rushing to her rescue. And then, my dears?
Yes?
The trident, crown, and throne will all be mine! Forgot.
As a result of your careless behavior.
Careless and reckless behavior.
The entire celebration was
ruined. Completely destroyed. This concert was going to be the pinnacle of my distinguished career.
Sebastian.
But I didn't mean to.
Ariel, listen. You've been given a gift. Your mother's voice. It's a wondrous talent. One that demands stewardship and care. So please, dear child, for the sake of her memory.
I know, Father, I know.
And it wasn't even Ariel's fault. We were going to come back straight away. But then the seagull started going on and on about human stuff.
Seagull? Human stuff? You went up to the surface?
Nothing happened.
You could have been seen by one of those barbarians.
Father, they're not barbarians.
They're dangerous. Nets, harpoons. You're my youngest.
I'm old enough to look after myself.
As long as you live under my reef, you'll obey my rules.
If you just listen to me for once.
That's the last time you're ever swimming to the surface. Understood?
Ugh, you're so unfair.
Life's unfair, darling. Get used to it.
Ugh. He's stubborn as a barnacle.
Teenagers, give him an inch and the swim all over you.
I can govern a kingdom, but I can't control my own daughter? Maybe I was too harsh.
Nonsense, sire. If you ask me, you haven't been tough enough.
I haven't.
Ariel is constant supervision. Someone to watch over her, to keep her out of trouble.
That's not a bad idea.
I'd say it's a right good one.
And you're just the crab to do it.
Haibo.
You heard me. From now on, Ariel is your responsibility.
Mine. But your majesty, I'm just a crustacean. She's a clever mermaid. Surely you ought to pick up someone higher on the evolutionary ladder.
If only I could make my father understand. I just don't see how a world that makes such wonderful things could be so bad.
Look at this stuff, isn't it neat? Wouldn't you think my collection's complete? Wouldn't you think I'm the girl who has everything? I've got gadgets and gizmos aplenty. I've got who's it's and what's it's galore.
You want thingamabobs? I've got 20.
But who cares? No big deal. I want. I wanna see him dancing, walking around on those,
what do you call them? Oh, feet.
Flipping your fins, you don't get too far. Legs are required for jumping, dancing, strolling along down the,
what's the word again?
Street, up where they walk, up where they run, up where they stand. I could be part of that world. What would I give if I could live out of these waters? What would I pay to spend a day warm on the sand? Betcha on land they'd understand. Bet that they don't reprimand their daughters. Bright young women, sick of swimming.
of swimming out of the sea.
Tell me, child, you got trouble in the mine?
Sebastian!
What is all this?
Just a few knickknacks I've collected, that's all.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself if your poor father knew I bought this place in.
You're not going to tell him, are you?
Oh, please, Sebastian, he'd never understand.
Ariel, down here is your home. The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there. The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you, what more is you looking for?
Under the sea, under the sea, darling, it's better, darling, it's wetter, take from me. I'm on the shore, the work all day, out in the sun, they slave away. While eating floating fruits and the floating under the sea.
Down here, all the fish is happy, as off through the waves they roll. The fish on the land ain't happy, they say cause they're in the bowl. But fish in the bowl is lucky, they're in for a worse fate. One day when the boss gets hungry, guess who gone beyond the plate?
Oh, oh, under the sea, under the sea. Nobody eat us fries and eat us in fricassee. We want the hand for trout to cook, under the sea we have to hook. We got no troubles, life is in bubbles under the sea.
Play the harp, the players play the bass and they sound sharp. The brass play the brass, the chop play the top. The fluke is the duke of soul. The ray he can play the lings on the strings. The trout rocking out, the blackfish he sings. The smelt and the spread, they know where it's set. And all that blowfish blow.
Look, a ship!
Under the sea, under the sea.
Child, that's what I'm talking about. Ariel? Hello? Or somebody's got to nail that girl's fins to the floor.
I don't want to be king.
I swore an oath to your dear father that I'll turn you from a roustabout into a royal and have you married to a princess by your next birthday, which is now just 3 days away.
Have you ever tried to take a princess sailing? It's a joke. Their dresses get caught in the rigging and most of them can't even swim.
You know, there's more to a woman than a flutter kick. This kingdom needs a queen.
Where am I going
to
find her, Gypsy? A girl who's as alive and as carefree as the sea itself. Where?
Perhaps you're not looking hard enough.
Wow, I've never seen a human this close before.
Me neither!
Shh! I thought you were an expert.
On their stuff, sure. But the sight of them, yikes, hideous.
I don't know, Scuttle. I think he's really handsome.
Trust me, Grimsby. When I come across the girl of my dreams, it'll hit me like lightning.
Party gainer coming! Captain King Chaitan must be angry indeed.
Batten the hatches, then everyone below deck.
The
and
ship's
quickly.
Listed badly.
Whoa, the wind's on the move!
Careful, secure the lead. Take the wheel.
Help!
Man overboard!
Prince Eric!
Was I too late?
I don't know. I can't make out a heartbeat.
No, look, he's breathing. Oh, Scuttle, just look at him. Isn't he the most beautiful thing you've ever seen?
Somebody
discovered.
Prince Eric, are you okay? Get away, you filthy bird.
A girl rescued me. She pulled me right out of the surf, and she was singing.
There, you took a terrible tumble, dear boy.
That voice, I can't get it out of my head.
Come with me, a night of sleep, and you'll be as good as new.
I have to find her and thank her for saving my life.
You've been hearing too many tall tales, dear boy.
No, she was real.
Of course, Prince Eric, as real as a mermaid on the rocks.
I don't know when, I don't know how, but I know something's starting right now. Watch and you'll see. Someday I'll be part of
She don't see me, she doesn't even speak. She treats me like sashimi left over from last week. You see her late at night, tossing in her ocean. Shoot, 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 shoot. She sighs and she swoops, and she's humming little tunes. Even has a sort of glow. What on earth could it be? Any hammerhead can see that sigh, that glow, that swoop. Oh no,
she's in love.
How they swish, well,
In love, my little Ariel? So that explains it. Just a minute there, Flounder.
Who, me?
You know Ariel as well as anybody. Who's the lucky merman?
Gee, I don't know. I didn't even know it was love until the second chorus.
Sebastian, any ideas?
I've tried to stop Isaiah, but she doesn't listen. I tell her, Ariel, you've got to stay away from those humans. They are nothing but trouble.
Humans? What about humans?
Who said anything about humans?
Sebastian, have you been keeping secrets from me?
No.
Where is that girl?
What did Scuttle call this one? A dittywomper? A thumbdoodle? Whatever it was, Prince Eric held it in his own strong, beautiful human hands.
Ariel, what is all this?
Father, they're my...
Human junk?
No, treasures.
Did you save a human from drowning?
They would have died.
That savage brute could have killed you, and it's my job to keep you safe from harm.
But he didn't frighten me. He made me feel wonderful. And besides, I'm not a child anymore.
No, well, you're certainly talking like one. He's a human.
Human.
And you're a mermaid.
Mermaid.
It doesn't matter. You don't understand. I wish Mother was here.
Ariel, I miss your mother just as much as you do. But I am still the king, and you're not to go to the surface ever again. Am I clear? I'm just trying to protect her, Sebastian.
She'll be all right, Saya. Just give her some time.
I hate him.
Ariel, don't say.
And some friend you turned out to be spilling everything.
I couldn't help it. He had me close in a clamp.
I don't need you. I don't need any of you. Go away. I said go away. I don't belong here. Only I could be up there.
Poor, sweet, misunderstood child. She has a very serious problem, hasn't she? Who will ease her woes and worries? Who will help her get a man? Perhaps the sea witch can.
Well, how did you?
She's been dying to help you.
Ursula? Help me?
Yes, but she can't leave her lair.
Then take me to her.
Of course.
Hello? Ariel, where did you go? Oh no, Sebastian!
Mistress of the Deep, you have a visitor.
I don't know if...
Now, mustn't get cold fins.
Don't be shy, Ariel, darling.
I shouldn't be here. Mother died because of you.
Oh, child, what happened to your dear mother was a terrible, unfortunate accident. Poor soul.
An accident?
Of course. I did my very best to save her.
You did? But Father told me...
The truth is, the ocean wasn't big enough for the both of your father and I. So he sent me here. And now I see he's pushing you away too.
He doesn't understand me.
Oh, but I do, dumpling. We're so alike, you and I. Girls with ambition. Now tell me absolutely everything.
I'm in love with someone. A human.
A prince, I hear. Quite a catch. Well, the answer is simple. You've got to become a human yourself.
You can do that?
My dear sweet child, it's what I live for, to help unfortunate merfolk like yourself. Poor souls with no one else to turn to. I admit that in the past I've been a nasty. They weren't kidding when they called me, well, a witch. But you'll find that nowadays I've mended all my ways, repented, seen the light and made a switch. True?
Yes.
And I fortunately know a little magic. It's a talent that I always have possessed. And around here lately, please don't laugh. I use it on behalf of the miserable, lonely, and depressed, pathetic, poor, fortunate souls.
This one longing to be thinner, that one wants to get the girl.
And do I help them?
Yes, indeed.
Those poor, fortunate souls.
So sad.
They come flocking to my cauldron, crying spells, Esther, please, and I help them?
Yes, you do.
No, it's happened once or twice. Someone couldn't pay the price, and I'm afraid I had to rake them across the coals. Yes, I've had the odd complaint, but on the whole, I've been a saint to those poor and fortunate souls. Spell that will turn you into a human for 3 days. Before the sun sets on the third day, you've got to get dear old Princey to kiss you. If you do, you'll stay human forever.
And if I don't?
You'll turn back into a mermaid and your soul will be mine forever. Life's full of tough choices, isn't it? Of course, there is one more thing. My fee.
But I don't have any.
I'm not asking for much, only your voice.
But if I give away my voice, how can I ever?
You'll have your looks, your pretty face, and don't underestimate the importance of body language. Come on, you poor, fortunate soul. Go ahead, make your choice. I'm a very busy woman and I haven't got all day. It won't cost much, just your voice. You poor, fortunate soul.
It's sad.
If you want to cross a bridge, my sweet, you've got to pay the toll. Take a gulp and take a breath and go ahead and achieve your goal. Flotsam, jetsam, now we've got a boys. The boss is on a roll. You poor, unfortunate soul. So how's about it, Cupcake?
If I become human, will I ever see my family again? My sisters, my father.
Not you, one, Princey Prue, or not. 5, 4, 3, 2.
Yes, yes, I'll do it.
That a girl, now. Beluga, Sefruga, come winds of the Caspian Sea. Larynxis, glissitis, as max laryngitis, la voce to me. Now sing. Sing your voice over to me.
Oh, 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 oh.
Now swim. Swim.
Okay.
Oh, child, what have you done?
Well, look who got beached. Hi, Ariel. Wait, there's something different about you. It's your hairdo. You've been using the dingle hopper, haven't you? No, I can't put my foot on it right now.
She's got legs, you idiot!
Ariel traded her voice with the sea witch to become human.
Not your beautiful pipes!
Yeah, see? Not a sound. What would her father say? I'll tell you what her father'd say. He'd say he's going to kill himself a crab. That's what he'd say.
Yes, and now Ariel got 3 days to make Prince Eric fall in love with her. And to prove it, he's got to kiss her.
A prince, well, I'll say.
Hey, what if we got... Shoo, shoo! Ah! Miss, are you all right? Of course, it's you. I've been looking for you everywhere. What's your name? Sore throat, huh? Oh, you don't speak at all. I'm sorry. I mistook you for somebody else. What's wrong? You're hurt? No, you need help? Well, I've got just the remedy. A warm bath and a hot meal should fix you right up. Come along now. The palace isn't far.
Way to go, Ariel!
Now that's what I call reeling him in.
Now I've got to follow. This is going to get me in real hot water.
Can you believe that guy? What a crab!
Today I'll create something to tame the pilot. Prepared in the classic technique. First you pound the fish flat with a mallet, slash through the skin, cut off the heads and pull out the bones. Oh, I love little fishes, don't you? Attention, attention! Le menu pour accessoire, escargot, lobster bisque, tuna tartare, holy mackerel, maintenant!
The things I do for that girl, over the wall, under the gutter, in through the window, now finally, someplace that's safe.
Le poisson. Poissons, les poissons, how I love les poissons. Love to chop and to serve little fish. First I cut off the heads and I pull out the bones. Ah, mais oui, ça c'est toujours délish. Les poissons, hee hee hee, ha ha ha. But the clever I hack them in two. I pull out what's inside and I serve it up right. Oh, I love little fishes, don't you? You're something for tempting the pilot. Prepared in the classic technique. First you pound the fish flat with the mallet. Then you slash through the skin, give the belly a slice. Then you rub some salt in. 'Cause that makes it taste nice. It's a fish, how you say, jamboree. Very fast, keep it smell. Fish kebabs, tuna melt. If it's grilled, it's been grilled to a tea. Fish lightly toasted and roasted and steamed. Tossed in the blender and tenderly creamed. Dish after dish, like you'd wish to have dreamed. Satalo, I've missed one.
Come here, little crab. I've something special prepared for you.
Imagine washing up like that on the beach. Must have been a horrible shipwreck. I don't suppose you'll ever know the truth. Why, you can't even speak. Oh, poor dear. Well, after you scrub in the tub, you're fresh as a daisy in a beautiful new frock.
Well, now I'm the one who's speechless.
It's been a long time since we've dined in the company of such loveliness.
She's lovely, isn't she, Your Highness?
Usually it's just me and Grim. He's got to look across the table at my ugly mug.
Well, the bath certainly worked its wonders. Your mystery guest is groomed for a groom, you might say.
Easy, old boy, easy. She has no voice.
Oh dear.
Oh, my dear girl, that's not how we do it.
My, isn't that unusual? Thank you.
Well, don't tell me she's fond of pipes. Can't say I blame her. That's an antique from Dusseldorf.
Sorry, old friend, but it looks like your pipe smoked you.
Very amusing, yes. Well, she certainly knows how to make you laugh.
Come on, Grimsby. Let's leave the young ones alone for a bit.
You should see the princesses Grimsby drags to dinner. So prim, so boring. But you. So, if you don't mind me asking, what was it? And accident when you were small? No, I didn't mean... Who needs words anyway? A smile says just as much sometimes. You're nimble on your feet, aren't you? Well, dancing beats small talk any day. It's the way your feet smile, or laugh, It lets you say so many things. Whisper, sing, or shout, but that's so much as a word. Try it.
Go on.
Like so. Just let your emotions tell your body what to do. See how much a single gesture can reveal. Let you get some sleep. Good night.
Out of the frying pan, into the fire. The things I do for you, young lady. Now I should march you right back home to your father, so you can be miserable the rest of your life. It's true, I got no backbone. All right, child, I'm in. But we've got to get that boy to Kishi before it's too late. Now, a few pointers from a clever crab to a little mermaid. First, you gotta bat your eyes like this. Then you gotta pucker your lips like this. Oh, that's good. Now put those two things together tomorrow and you got that boy in the palm of your hand.
No girls ever dared to join me out here. Too afraid they'd muddy their shoes. But not you. Peaceful, isn't it? Not another soul for miles and miles. If only.
Hi, guys. What's happening?
Nothing's happening.
Shh. They spent all morning on the horseback, and then an afternoon picnic. And now this. And not so much as a peck on the cheek.
Oh, no. There's only one day left.
So, how about this weather?
We gotta do something, and quick!
But what?
This could be our last chance.
We gotta create the right kind of mood.
Like candlelight and champagne?
Nonsense. You don't take all that. Everything we need, we got right here. Percussion. Strings. Wings. Words.
To know your name. Maybe I could guess. Alexandra? Annabelle? Beatrice?
Ariel. Her name is Ariel.
Ariel? Ariel. Hey, that's kind of pretty. Okay. Ariel.
Sha la 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 la.
don't. Lock that kiss.
Whoa, what happened? Ariel, are you all right? We ought to head back anyway. Gotta rest up for my birthday tomorrow. Old Grimsby's planning a ball to help me find the one with that voice. He wants me married by sunset, or else.
Why? What?
With us 3 whole days already. It's been such a treat. Now that the princes are here to sing for Prince Eric so he can finally choose his bride. Just stand back there while the royalty mingles. It's sure to be quite a show.
Welcome, dear friends, to our contest, the first that our kingdom has ever seen. We gather today for a vocal display so our prince may at last choose the queen. These 11 princesses possess the most accomplished voices in the land. Tonight, one of you will join Prince Eric on the throne. May the best woman win. One of these lovely voices matches the music in your heart.
I wish I could say yes, but she's not here.
The sun is nearly set and your birthday will soon be over. You must choose a mate.
Ariel?
Oh, dear one.
For heaven's sake, child.
Quiet, Grimsby. Go ahead, Ariel.
Oh, child, poor lost child.
I had so hoped, dear Eric, that you would find love somewhere in this room.
But I have, Grimsby. I've just been too blind to see it. Come here, Ariel. That's the voice, but tell her the competition is over. I've already made my decision.
Such a gorgeous sunset, and on the third day too. Time's up, you lose.
Ariel, what's wrong? She's jumped into the ocean. I have to go after her.
Oh no, the worst is happening. I've got to help.
Ariel, I'm worried. I haven't seen you for 3 days. I've come to apologize. Ariel?
Most merciful Triton.
Sebastian, what are you doing here? And where's Ariel?
Boy, she'd be so angry if she knew I was here.
I entrust my youngest daughter to you, and what happens? She disappears? I ought for you to be cracked and shelled.
He almost was, your greatness.
What tragedy will it take?
A tragedy involving Tassiwi.
What?
Don't be a guppy. Don't be a guppy. You see, your majesty, these 2 slippery eels came to Ariel and took her to Ursula. Then she traded her voice for a pair of legs.
You bartered away a voice to become human?
Oh, yes. No.
Yes, and now that child has given up her very soul.
Oh, Ariel, what have you done? Come, we must save my daughter.
Goodbye to your prince. You're mine now, mermaid. Get ready to spend the rest of your days as my slave.
Ursula!
King Triton, you're right on cue.
What have you done to my daughter?
Nothing. She's done it all to herself. Trading her voice away, and for what? Human heartbreak?
Give her back to me.
Not on your life.
It so happens that your daughter made a bargain.
No!
Swapped her voice to land a man up where it's dry.
Is it binding? Goodness, yes. Unbreakable, unless.
Unless?
There is a little something we could try.
Go on.
Yes. Perhaps we could arrange a sort of trade-off. Maybe swap your daughter's soul for, say, your own.
What?
Make the steal and set her free, or else she comes with me to suffer through eternity alone.
It's not my soul you're after, it's my power.
Now which would you rather be, king of the sea or father to your little girl?
The trident is a great responsibility, Ursula.
Nonsense, trite one. Hand it over. The oceans belong to me!
And now you poor unfortunate souls, time's up, you're through. Now the power of Poseidon has been once again made whole, the magic of the trident and the shell in my control. And now dark shall reign forever over ocean, sea and shore.
Now see for yourself how banishment feels.
You poor unfortunate soul.
What's this? A human ship?
Who are you? And what have you done with Ariel?
Careful, Princey Pooh. The water's looking awfully choppy.
Beware, monster. King Triton holds over these seas.
Not anymore.
I won't let you harm her.
Ha! Captain, we've got to jump back or she'll pull us under.
Look out, the shell.
You fool!
You witch. Not so fast, Guppy.
Stop there, sea snake.
Look who's talking. No matter, I have what I want now and you don't.
You may have my father's trident, but you'll never have his power.
Impertinent mermaid, I'll dispatch you just as easily as I eliminated your mother.
So father was right?
Yes, father was right. And soon you'll see just how insignificant the merfolk become when Ursula's in charge. With trident in hand, I shall unleash the power of Poseidon and destroy you all! Wait! Oh no! Stop!
Are you all right, child?
Yes, thank you for your help.
Not such a guppy anymore, am I?
No, you're the best friends a girl could ask for.
Ariel!
Oh, father, I've caused so much trouble. Could you ever forgive me?
Why, I've never been prouder. Somehow in the blink of an eye, when my back was turned, you grew up. You love him very much, don't you? You belong to his world now.
Thank you, Father. Thank you so much.
Just remember, when you hear the surf roar at night and the tingle of salt in the air, it's just your father checking in on his little girl.
Ariel, who are you?
I'm her father, King Triton, and you're the human who came to her rescue?
With all due respect, sir, Ariel is the one who has done the rescuing.
The king of the sea, and she's his daughter?
Does that upset you?
No, I'm just relieved she's royalty.
Your Majesty, at last I've found someone who makes me eager to seize the future and claim my birthright as king. But if I slip out to sea sometimes, I hope she'll be right there beside me. May I have her hand?
Ariel can speak for herself.
She can?
What would I give to live where you are? What would I pay to stay here beside you? What would I give to see you?
Just you and me.
op de bas. Ek gaan vir surprise toe, daar gaan ek my naals doen. Sê dra die broek. Sê dra die broek. Say, draw the blue. Talk to me in the park. Walk on like a pole and dance like a park. I can't pick it apart. Pass on by the